today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be teaching 16 little girls how to become a fashion designer. We're going to teach them streetwear today. So he's saying over here, he's been in New York a lot for modeling and a lot. He's saying that the boots look very New York. Would you agree?
Yes.
All the way up?
Yes.
And then I think from the waist up, she looks like Portland, because I have a friend named Alexis who looks exactly like that. All right, go ahead. What about colors?
I think the best part is how into it the kids are with just fashion and style and streetwear. I think everything is, I mean, I even took a step back and I was looking at it and I'm like, wow, there's this many young kids, young girls that are so into it that it made me smile. And the fact that we're a part of it is really cool.
I want women and men to feel confident and just to feel proud of themselves and proud of what they wear and what they do.
This is what I'm going to make my streetwear.
Let me see.
The shirt I'm going to do.
Oh, that's really good.
Okay. Very cool.
And I'm sure that I can make that.
I'm going to fix it, though.
How's it going over here, Rocky?
Really good. Really good. A lot of the girls are liking the animal prints, I'm noticing. Something I'm a fan of.
Yeah, I'm noticing a lot of opposite, actually. A lot of color, purples, bright colors. The girls really like the shoes, into the shoes, and they're doing a really good job. This is a lot of fun.
Yeah? Go ahead.
I like this Kesha's song, like it's one of my favorite songs called like Glow, and I think that like early like punk outfit, yeah, you know, like a leather jacket, like some like very like platform shoes, probably, yeah, glitter and studs and beat up denim.
And I'm really excited about it because to see such advancements in like a 10 or 12 year old, like the way they're drawing, some of the language that they're using, it's very refreshing to see that.
So you want to make the clothes, that kind of stuff, but earlier we talked about how do you sell it, how do you pitch it, and that's why I want you guys to write that stuff down and come up with those words. Does that make sense? And what they're doing is they're going a step further. They're taking those words and those inspirations, that kind of stuff, and they have parties. They have these big fashion shows, these big events, they have music artists come in, they have graffiti artists, that kind of stuff. What you could do is have a beach party. You call everyone you know, you tell the newspapers, that kind of stuff, advertise it, and then you drive everyone down, you know, to the beach, and you have a giant party on the beach, and everyone's wearing your stuff, and you have a fashion show right there on the sand, barefoot. Wouldn't that be fun?
So Bobby came in last minute, and it's going to be a special treat. No one knows he's coming, and he actually brought some gifts for everybody. What'd you bring?
I brought some shirts.
And what are you going to talk about? Like, influences, or?
Just talk about being original. Finding something that you're passionate about.
There you go.
If you do that, then you'll probably be in a good spot. I know that when I was little, when I was listening to music, I would listen to rappers, and they would talk about they're in their Jordans, and it made me want to go get Jordans because they were talking about wearing Jordans. I think it's really cool what you guys are doing at this really young of an age, because if you just get your mind to think about stuff differently at this young of an age, when you get older, it's going to be so much easier.
So Tony, how did you get into what we're doing today?
Tacee Web called me from the Portland Design Collective, and she talked about this camp going on where they're going to bring in all these little kids that want to be designers, and asked me if I would teach a streetwear thing. And my first thought was, I'm probably the least person qualified. I don't even like kids. but at the same time, like, I kind of remember, you know, back in the day, being that same age and kind of being excited about fashion. And I would have loved to have this opportunity, and I would have loved somebody who does men's streetwear, you know what I mean, who's a little bit more aggressive, that kind of stuff, to come push me, you know, to take a risk and go for it. I want one of these kids to make it big. I want to find out 10 years from now that one of them, like Brian said earlier, is the next Vera Wang, you know, or the next Versace, whoever. I want one of them to really succeed, and I want to be able to look back and say, I influenced that person. I made an impact in their life. And although what they're designing now is way more advanced than what we're teaching them today, it would be the ultimate compliment and so rewarding to find out that you made an impression, you made an impact, and it had a ripple effect that really influenced the masses. I mean, that was so cool.
Right now. Good job. Oh, good job. Perfect.
Good pose. Confident. Very good confidence. Very good.
You want to pause? Just soak it up. Just take this picture and then walk off. As long as you're having fun, everyone else will be fast. Really good.
There we go.
Nice.
Woo! Nice pose. All the way down here.
Oh, smile.
Woo! Perfect.